If the Congress wants to accept partition, it can do so only by treading over my dead body, said Mahatma Gandhi. If devotion to one's own country amounts to a sin, I admit I have committed that sin. If it is a meritorious, I humbly claim the merit thereof. Nathuram Godse.
Right. So the first one is what Gandhi said.
Yeah.
He took the Hindus into confidence and achieved their verdict in in his favor, saying that we will not participate, we will not vivisect the country.
Right.
Then immediately they were elected. Within 2 months, they made a resolution of partition of India.
Yes.
And the country was partitioned.
No.
We should have gone to the public again that we are going to vivisect the country. You have voted us for not vivisecting the country.
No. Mr. Godse, we are with you on that. It is decided that such a good country as India, which was united for centuries, was divided by British with or without Gandhi. But when you are talking of vivisection, I say and I firmly believe that more than Gandhi, it was Nehru who divided the country and made it into 30 parts because of linguistic division. No. Why are you not blaming Nehru for that?
If you ask me, we don't praise Nehru.
Okay.
For the reason that he is equally responsible for deceiving the people.
That's right.
Like Gandhi.
Right.
And there should have been somebody to deal with Nehru.
But why was Nehru selected by Gandhi, first of all?
That is different.
Yeah.
That is because he was his, what we call, a staunch follower. He did not like Vallabhbhai.
Right.
Nehru. So that was.
Vallabhbhai was a better leader, in fact.
Anyway.
Yeah.
So nature also favored Nehru. Had nature given the life of Nehru to Vallabhbhai, the country's fate would have been different.
Today, some people say, with an Italian foreigner ruling India, is a worse situation than that existed in 1948. In such a situation, some people think that Sonia Gandhi's life is also in danger.
She was the most wise lady who refused to become the Prime Minister.
I see.
Trying that game also. The most wise person. Because, you know, she saved herself first and her party. Because her party would have been splintered or splitted into many factions.
If she had become the Prime Minister.
She would not have become the Prime Minister. Because her own people would have opposed her. All that have been elected are not necessarily in favor of his hard premiership, prime ministership.
Okay. Is there any message that you would like to give to India?
Yes.
And to the Indian youth?
Right.
What is the message?
The army should be strong enough. In whosoever's hands the government may be. Because you are having talks with Pakistan, alright. You must not forget we have created an enemy nation just on our laps. And that is what we call Pakistan. On one side it is Bangladesh, on the other. And they hate us not with the wish of having.
Sir, I asked you what is your message to the youth.
Right.
You are telling me that a nation should be strong and should have army. These are two different things.
For that, it is the job of the youths to join army in maximum numbers.
To do what?
As a soldier.
Why?
Right from. The youths are the future of India.
Yeah, so?
And so if the army is strong enough, we should have that mind that I am in the army without my nation.
But army is the root cause all over the world of divisions, walls that separate people. The amount of money that is used on army, if it was used on development, poverty will end, illiteracy will end, inequality will end, there will be health for everybody, there will be shelter and clothes for everybody.
And one thing will end further.
What is
the
that?
The nation will end.
You are talking of border world. When the Berlin Wall is falling, you are thinking of creating another world between Hindustan and Pakistan. On the one hand, you are talking of united India, Akhand Bharat. On the other hand, you are telling youth to join the army and divide the India. Defend the India.
The difference is, in Europe, at the time of war, the nations were opposed to one another.
Right.
It may be Germany, it may be France, it may be England. And now what you talk about is the position that there is no reason of any enmity of that type.
Right.
In you.
Yeah.
Here we are freshly born independent. For our independence
agreed.
Is very wrong.
Agreed.
And therefore, if you want to settle up your independence, for that purpose you must have all the necessary things. And then you can develop as the once we become Hindu Rashtra,
right,
they will be the first to join hands with us on the national demand. We are not.
No, but why should we become Hindu Rashtra?
No, it should be here because every nation has got some religious faith as their national.
No, but religion, as history tells us throughout the centuries, has been the stumbling block of progress and peace and safety of people. Religion has killed more people than any other war. In fact, more wars have been fought in the name of religion. So why are you propagating an idea which is antagonistic to human evolution?
To stop the wars, you have to make wars.
No, that is a hackneyed sentence which we don't agree with.
Otherwise,
we can't stop the war by another war. By
the invasions are there, not in order to have the hold on the land,
right,
but hold on the culture.
Okay.
To abolish the culture.
Right.
So when that thing is there, that is your standing enemy.
Okay.
And when you have created that, you cannot, on one side you are talking with the ministry or ministerial level and all this stuff, all right. But if you sleep, that, we had good talk with that. The attacks will be there.
No, but have you got any plan to unite Pakistan and Bangladesh back into India?
Yes, yes.
What is your plan?
First of all,
that is my last question to you.
First of all, to get elected in the name of Hindus. No.
In the name of Hindus, where? Get elected from where?
From, well, throughout the country. So
that is India, but what
BJP,
I have asked
BJP,
you.
Even BJP had got elected in the name of Hindus.
Yeah,
no,
no.
They are humble.
BJP is humbug, okay.
Humbug in the sense, I mean, say dishonest.
People. Yeah, these are dishonest.
Dishonest this way. They write Ram Janmabhoomi or say Ram Temple and all this.
Right, right.
And once they be in the chair,
yeah,
they said, no, we are not nothing.
Correct,
to
yeah.
Actually,
no, that is the coalition politics.
That
is the coalition politics.
No, and therefore they defeated.
But
were,
supposing they had
they
got absolute majority.
Defeated.
No, that is beside the point. Supposing BJP gets or were to get absolute majority and they were not under the pressure of coalition politics,
right,
would BJP follow the Hindu agenda? Yes or no?
Not necessarily. No.
They wouldn't follow?
No, I don't.
So in other words, BJP is not a Hindu party?
No, not in Hindu party at all.
Oh,
I
see.
If you see their first agenda,
okay,
or first what you call constitution. Their first constitution.
Right.
In the name of Janasangha.
Okay.
You will not find the word Hindu over there.
Okay. So what is your definition of Hindu?
Hindu, the nationals of India.
So what is your definition of Hinduism then?
Hinduism is the
definition, same. I said. Definition.
Definition is that यस्य भारत भूमिका आसिन्धु सिन्धु पर्यन्ता यस्य भारत भूमिका पितृभु पुण्यभूश्चैव स वै इन्द्रप्रस्थः.
ओके,
हूएवर टेक्स दिस लैंड टू बी हिज होली प्लेस एंड फादर लैंड इज अ हिंदू.
ओके,
सो योर फादर लैंड इज हियर एंड व्हेन यू टच व्हाट वी कॉल दिस हिंदू स्पिरिट देयर इज नो रीजन फॉर यू टू बी कन्वर्टेड.
I see. But then, even the Muslims who were born here, ipso facto, according to your definition, become Hindu then. Because they were part of it. They are part of India.
They agree.
Just because they follow a different religion, do they become otherwise?
They become otherwise for the reason the religion itself teaches. जब हराम के मैंने पी जाए जब मुशरिक जही कहीं पाओ उसको घेरो उसको कत्ल करो. अगर वो तौबा करे नमाज कायम करे ज़कात दे तो उसका मार्ग छोड़ दो अल्लाह बड़ा दयालु है. और जो मुशरिक तुम्हारे आस पास है उनको घेरो उनको कत्ल करो. The religion which treats hatred of others is no religion at all.
Now, precisely, then we come to the Indian constitution, which is a unique constitution in all over the world. All other constitutions are religious based. American constitution, we have to swear by the Bible. In England, it is Protestant. In Spain, it is Roman Catholic. In Portugal, Roman Catholic. In Pakistan, it is Quran. But India is the only country on the face of the earth which gives equal status regardless of their religion to everyone and considers you as a citizen of a great country regardless of what your personal belief is. Now in that case, why do you insist that somebody should become Hindu?
Our constitution or the method, we should not technically a guidance for others. If we are mistaken, we have to correct ourselves. If a Muslim swears by the constitution, he would not do anything that would harm the country. In Nehru's time, I give you one example, only for the sake of example. One minister, a Muslim, he had this connection with our arms were to come and this ship was to go to Mumbai for unloading. The ship came to Karachi. Something happened and it was unloaded in Pakistan. An empty ship was shifted to Mumbai. So a minister who swears by the constitution of India would not do it because he is a Muslim. But if he has a preference that he is a Muslim, he would do it. So examples also have happened.
Now let me conclude this by saying, etymologically, the word Hindu as taught to us in Vedas is Vasudeva Kutumbakam, that the entire world is my family.
Correct.
Similarly, the word Catholic etymologically means all-embracing.
Universal.
Universal. So where is the fight?
Fight is in Hindus. Whichever God you pray, all the prayer reaches the main God.
In other words, are you saying that there is main God and sub-gods?
Right. Whether they are sub-gods or not, you call them, you don't call them, you call them God in God. But whosoever, it may be Khandoba, it may be your Pandari Nath and whatever.
But we have created devs, we have also created devils, Danavs. So
we have created Deva
and Danavs. So why are we fighting?
For the sake of humanity. We should understand that.